Thank you for calling MSD Solicitors. We are a trusted law firm specializing in immigration and family law services. Please hold while we connect your call to a member of our team.
This call is being recorded.
Hi, can I please speak to Tasneem?
Can I take your name, please?
This is Uzam Suhail.
Right, just hold on a moment. Let me just get your... Are you an existing client with us?
Well, actually, I spoke to her last December. I'm someone who is a refugee in the United Kingdom. I basically had to apply for an ILR. So I just needed to find out the timelines of when to apply. That's all. And then I will proceed. She'd also send me a court and ask me to transfer money, but she told me that it's too early. So if her or someone can just speak to me right now to tell me the timelines, I will then proceed. And
unfortunately, Tasneem's just on annual leave at the moment. But
is anyone else there?
Details up in front of me in our system, and I'll just see if anybody's available from the immigration department. Is that okay?
Yes. What do you need from me? Sorry.
Just hold. I'll just.
Okay. Sure. Sure. I'll hold the line. Yeah. My first name is Uzzam.
Uzzam.
Last name is Sohail.
Yes. I'm going to just confirm your email address just for formality.
Ilham.
Yeah.
bhuttu@outlook.com.
Perfect. Got your details here. I'll just pop you on hold for another.
Yeah, second. And just to confirm, the number that you should be holding on your telephone, your system. Is +44 7858 657 156.
Yes, that's the one we've got on our system.
Yeah, because
the one to contact you now.
Ma'am, I'm calling you from a different number, but the one that you should save is the one that I kindly shared with you. And I'll just stay on hold. If you want me, I can repeat the number again.
No, that's fine. I'll just pop you on hold for a sec and I'll see if anyone's available.
All right, thank you. Hello.
Hi, thank you for holding. So I just wanted to know what application are you looking to apply for?
Well, I'm a refugee in United Kingdom. I need to apply for the next step. I think the next steps are the independent leave to remain, right? So ILR.
Yeah, you're looking to apply for indefinite leave to remain.
Yeah, I'm a refugee. I was given an asylum back in 2019. I had spoken to one of your colleagues, Tasneem, back in December. So she said it's a bit too early, so I just wanted to understand the timelines, when to apply for it. This is just the application.
How long have you been in the UK for?
Oh, I've been in the UK since 2015. I'm an approved asylum.
How long have you had discretionary leave for?
Oh, well, it was approved in September 2019. It's expiring on the 28th of August 2000. And...
2024. August. Okay, so
it was 5 years. No, I understand. No, what I meant to say is I have been in the country for more than 5 years. I have had the asylum since 2019. My leave to remain card, my resident permit card, has an expiry date or dated August 2024. I need to.
So you have to have held the refugee status for 5 years.
Yes, so that would complete 5 years. So that's the expiry date.
When were you granted it?
September 2019.
No, I completely understand
that, yeah. So that's all I just wanted to confirm that.
Yeah, so if it was granted in September, you just have to wait till September, and by then your 5 years would have been completed and you can apply for indefinitely to remain.
Sure, there are two questions I have. I completely take your point and thank you for that. I was given an asylum in 2019, I have been in the country from prior to that. I was here on a visa, and the asylum was given prior to the expiry of the visa. So I've been in the country since 2015, one. Two, if the card expires in September and I go into an application just at that time, what is the lag time? When do I have to file it to, you know, I have to ensure that I remain legal. That's the only document I have.
The application before the expiry.
So when did you say it expired?
28th of August 2024.
Yes, yeah, so
we would advise that you submit the application before then. How many days before then? You can do
it up to 28 days before. So I can do it now? No, sorry, it's 28 days. Only 28 days. I understand there is no fee for a refugee.
No, there is no fee.
Okay. And then if we go through, I mean, Tasneem, it's too early to do anything now is what you're telling me. Basically, yeah. My understanding is you're saying we have to apply 28 days before. And then, whatever documentation you guys require. I was given an asylum in September 2019. The card expires on the 28th of August. And you want me to, as you guided, should apply 28 days before. And how long does it take for the ILR to come through?
Around 3 to 6 months.
So when the card expires and the ILR is still being reviewed, process, what happens then?
So your status would still remain legal because you've got a pending application.
Okay. Okay.
So, yeah, you wouldn't be illegal.
Okay, I understand. Because obviously I was given an asylum based on circumstances that still remain. I mean, it was on HIV, it was based on the fact, sexual orientation, abuse and torture, blah, blah, blah. Those things, obviously, I have that understanding. I'm on benefits, but I just wanted to understand when can I apply, and you've guided me to come 28 days before, and then that's how the process will roll. So when there is
You can come before then, and then we can start drafting the application and have it ready.
Okay, so when do you think is a good time to start when the application to meet you guys, or however you want me to proceed?
You can bring back mid-July.
Mid-July. And what is your fees on the matter?
I'll just try and find it out for you. Hold on a moment.
Thank you. Yes.
Hi, so we usually charge around £1,000.
£1,000. And that is all in to make the application for the ILR. The Home Office has no fees for the refugee.
But with counseling, her fees might differ a bit.
I'm sorry, what will it differ with?
With counseling, her fees might be different.
Sorry, repeat that. Why will it be different? So I couldn't hear that. roughly £1,000. Okay, now I understand. Yeah. And you're saying approach you guys around July, and you're saying in 28 days and everything. I just want to ensure that I'm not in any situation out of policy or etc. No, completely understand. May I have your good name, please?
My name is Tiger.
Pfizer?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you. You have my contact details, yeah? Okay, thank you. Thank you. This is Uzam, all right? Thank you. Bye-bye.